Hey everyone, this is Big Mike, and this is my review of Zack Snyder's Justice League. Yes, the day has finally arrived where the fans have spoken and wished this into existence, like literally. So let's dive right in. Now, I do want to make a statement first off. I am going to do spoilers, but I'm going to do my normal review first, and I'm going to kind of give you my score of the movie. What I felt about it, and then I'll dive into spoilers. So I'll let you know when the spoilers come up. So if you want to watch this video and you haven't seen it yet, you still can for the first part of the video, and then turn away when I start the spoiler talk. So here we go. First off, let's start here. Justice League, which is Joss Whedon's version. It was okay. Like, I didn't think it was too horrible, but yeah, I mean, I wanted to see Zack Snyder's original version. Was this better? Yes, this was better. Now let me backtrack a bit, because everyone wants to do the Marvel versus DC comparison. I'm gonna give you a little background. I've always been a Marvel and DC fan of the comics first, and then, you know, of the movies. So, is the MCU on a higher level than the DCEU? In my opinion, yes. However, I still enjoy both sides. So, Man of Steel. A lot of people loved it or hated it, right? I'm one of those people. I thought Man of Steel was just fine. You know, I really enjoyed watching Man of Steel. Batman v Superman theatrical cut, wasn't feeling it, okay? The Ultimate Edition, however, is watchable. I do believe the Batman v Superman extended edition is watchable, okay? Now let's get into like some of the good ones. Wonder Woman, the first one, was amazing. I loved Aquaman. Shazam is probably one of my favorites. But yeah, like, I'm not a DCEU hater. So I look forward to these movies as I was looking forward, you know, to this one. So to get all of that out of the way, yes, you can like both. It's perfectly fine. And I'm one of those people. So now let's break down the 4 hour long Zack Snyder's Justice League. Now, do I feel personally that it could have been a little shorter? Yes, it could have been cut down a little bit. My gripes mostly were with the extended slow-mo. I thought it was entirely too much slow motion. Like, not every action scene needed to have slow-mo in it, okay? But every action scene did have slow-mo in it. So that's where we were at this point. Now, other than that, I really enjoyed Zack Snyder's vision a little more. I'm so glad we got to get Darkseid in this movie. Even though he was just hinted at, I really enjoyed seeing Darkseid in this movie. I thought he was done well. Even Steppenwolf was way better than the Justice League version. He was way more menacing. He was very, you know, no holds barred. I love this version of Steppenwolf as well. So those things did work for me. As far as, you know, the upgrades, the story was more cohesive, of course. But like I said, I do think it could have been shaved down maybe about a half an hour or so. Would have probably served it better. So my overall score of Zack Snyder's Justice League, I would have to give it a 7 out of 10, which is like kind of average, you know. And I, like I said, I enjoyed it. Did I think it was as epic as some people said? No, I don't think it was as epic as some people said, but I give Zack Snyder's Justice League 7 out of 10. Now, now's the time, let's say, to jump right into spoilers. So I'm going to jump into spoilers. If you haven't seen it, you don't want to be spoiled, you know, turn away, and I'll talk about some of the things in depth that I did and didn't like. So, first off, what I did like, how they built this whole vision, you know, of the future. Because, so at the end of the movie, of course, they beat Steppenwolf just like they did in the Whedon cut. Not just like it, but they still beat him, okay? But Barry had to run back in time, okay, to reverse it, because at first they lost. So Barry had to run back in time and fix things, and he did. But then after Wonder Woman cut off Steppenwolf's head, yes, cut off his head, Darkseid told Desaad to ready the armada because he was going to do it the old-fashioned way and go invade with all the warships and everything like that. And we did get a glimpse of the nightmare future. We saw how Darkseid killed Aquaman, killed Wonder Woman, and how Bruce had to have an alliance with Deathstroke, Cyborg, Flash, Mira, and also Jared Leto Joker. Now that scene, I understand why I was put in there as kind of, you know, a nod to say, hey, let's put this Batman and this Joker together finally, okay? Did I like Jared Leto's performance any more than I did in the Suicide Squad? I mean, not really. Jared Leto still is one of the least favorite Jokers, I think, among, you know, fans and even me alike. I think he's one of the bottom tier. Not that he's too horrible in his take, but I'm just not a real fan of his Joker. I would like to see more, but I'd like to see him tweak his performance a little bit, but then that's kind of like stepping on his art, so, you know, whatever. But there is room to make more, you know, out of this. I wouldn't mind seeing this vision come to fruition, or fruition. I can't talk today. So I would like to see that vision, you know, expanded by Zack Snyder, just to see, because Joker mentioned when he was talking to Batman about alternate timelines. So that being said, I think that was kind of like a mulligan to say, hey, if Zack Snyder is greenlit to do it, and DC or Warner Brothers is saying, hey, the Justice League version is still our canon, you can still say, well, hey, I mean, Joker did say alternate timeline, so you can still do this and say, well, this could have, should have, you know, happened, or kind of happened, or it happened in a different universe. So those things, you know, I actually, like I said, outside of Jared Leto Joker's performance, which I didn't hate, but I didn't love it either. I did like how that worked, and like I said, the story was just much more cohesive in this one. I did overall enjoy it. I just wish that they would have not done so much slow-mo, you know, because that would have made it, you know, just a bit, that would have made it just a bit better. So if you saw it, let me know what you thought. Drop them down in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, hit that bell for notifications so you can be notified of all my latest content. And once again, thanks for watching, and see you next time.